Fix my eyes on the things that I can't knees hit the ground.
To agreement as I lead in prayer and to follow with your own intercession. Father, we praise you for your sovereign wisdom that is beyond that of ours, that your foolishness is so much greater than the wisest of us. I pray that the leaders of Israel and the leaders that are to come will first enter your rest, because when we are rested, listen to reason well. We are able to be peaceable. But I pray that as rest can only come from you, Jesus, and not from anything else, help the leaders come to that revelation. And I pray that your wisdom will be heard by the leadership in various ways, that your wisdom and your great love will subdue any conflict, will subside any disagreements among the leadership, so that they can work together to bring forth actions that will be pleasing to your eyes. Lord, I ask that you will also appoint future leaders filled with your wisdom, filled with your anointing, that will be advocates of your causes, advocates of your purposes, advocates of your plans, and help your plans of prosperity for the nation of Israel be fulfilled. Let's pray. Father God, I pray that just as you gave Bezalel your spirit to anoint him with creativity to construct the tabernacle, that that same spirit lives and dwells inside the people of Israel. And also as you created the heavens and the earth with such intricate creative details that no other man could possibly think of, that as sons and daughters made in your image, the nation of Israel also has that same potential for creativity as well. Holy Spirit, won't you just break out in the people of Israel and bless them with creative, never-before-seen ideas, entrepreneurial ideas that will bring forth world-renowned businesses to bring greater blessings to the welfare of Israel. And I pray for a restoration of hope and ideas into those wanting to enter into the arts and entertainment. Let there be no broken dreams. Holy Spirit, I just pray that you will bless the future artists, the future filmmakers, the future musicians, entertainers with creativity that will allow them to succeed and shine their lights in their respective industries that desperately need your presence. I also pray that the people of Israel will find artistic ways to use the influential tool that is media to spread awareness of issues and events Israel is currently going through that not many are aware about, and will also stir up the hearts of people around the world to intercede for the nation. I declare that Israel will be looked to as a model, a pioneer, a forerunner of creativity, that Israel will rise up and influence the rest of the world through its creativity. Let's pray. Thank you. heavens, you are there. And if we make our bed in the depths, you are there right beside us. I pray that Israel remembers that you have not forgotten them, that you have not left them, you have not forsaken them, that you have never abandoned them, even if their present circumstances make it seem that way. That they can come to a place where no matter what hardship they go through, they can say with confidence, with boldness, God with us. Father, won't you also show your children that you are a loving Father who has great plans for them, especially to those going through any disappointment or discouragement. I pray that they are reminded you are a God who takes hold of their right hand, meaning you are right there beside them to encourage them, to protect them, to pick them up, and to give them guidance. Jesus, you also say, blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. So I ask that God, you will comfort the people of Israel, primarily those who have lost loved ones to injustice, to war, to sickness, to things that seem out of their control. I pray that God, that you are in the one who's in control of their lives and that you promise them great blessings. I ask that in spite of their great losses, that you ultimately are a God who uses it for the good of those that love you. Remind them that you are a loving Father. Remind them that you are good. I pray that you will lift the heads of the downcast up and restore hope and joy in them. Let's pray. that you are doing just that for the nation of Israel that is loved by you. I ask that Israel will receive tremendous miracles and blessings, first in the realm of finances. Let anyone that is struggling in finances struggle no more. I pray wealth and riches will be in their houses, that there will be a multitude of testimonies where you have brought people out of poverty into great wealth throughout Israel. God, you are Jehovah Jireh, the Lord who provides. I also pray that the prayers of the people of Israel will be answered, and that the things that they desire and need will be provided for supernaturally, in ways that the only way to explain the provisions they receive is that they're from you, Lord. God, not only are you the Lord who provides, you are the Lord who also heals. I ask that you place your hands of healing on those struggling with any injuries and any disease, and break down the demonic trespasses that are causing these sicknesses. I declare testimonies of healing to break out throughout the nation of Israel. And I pray that all these signs and wonders that we are contending for, that they ultimately point their witnesses to you, Jesus, the Son of God, as the way, the truth, and the life, the way to life everlasting. That all they can do is give you glory, just as people did when you, Jesus, performed miracles in your ministry. Let's pray. To that very revelation, Lord Father. And I just pray that ultimately Israel will gaze upon you and gaze upon you, Jesus, as a truth, as a way to salvation. I pray that you are doing amazing things and that you are not finished with them, Jesus. You are not finished with Israel. I pray that the prayers that we pray today, it will come into reality. That the things that we're contending for, that it will happen, and that you are listening attentively. Just thank you so much for all the things that you've done, Father. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Revival, Holy Spirit, fire. Father, we know that with just one word from your mouth, kingdoms fall and kingdoms rise. We thank you, Father, that everything is in your hands. As we lift up to you, Israel, your nation, your beloved one, we pray, Father, that we would see your kingdom come, your will done here on earth as it is in heaven over this nation. We thank you, Father, that you have not given up on her, that you continue, Lord God, to see her, Lord God, with eyes of love. And we will see a day where you will redeem your beloved one. And we will see her, Lord God, rising up to her calling. We thank you, God, for these things. We trust that you're moving at the sound of our voice as we call out to you. There's fire that is falling. There are prayers that are being answered. All of these things mobilized by the power of the prayer of the saints. We thank you, Father, for these things. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight. We hope that you are blessed. We hope that you continue to pray on behalf of Israel. It's a prayer topic that often is hard to grab a hold of, but once God gives us his heart for his people, there's really no going back. We'll continue to grow a heart for the nation of Israel. So we thank you so much for joining us. We hope that you are blessed. And next week we have, once again, a Wednesday morning watch at 9:30 in the morning. Otherwise, we'll see you once again on Thursday evening.